Hi, this what you see is a manual desoldering pump. So today in this video, I'm going to convert it into an electric pump. Now this is a high temperature sleeve and I have used it in between the desoldering pump tip and the nozzle. Now this one is another high temperature sleeving, but it is very thin, and this is my heating filament from an old damaged heater. So I've taken a little wire out of it. So what I'm going to do is use this filament and slide it inside the sleeve carefully so that I don't accidentally break it. So I'm going to leave this much and it's going to be useful afterwards. Now we are going to need another thin metal wire. It is not a filament, but it is going to hold this filament or heating filament strongly on the tip. So let's take it out a little more and start with this. Now if you look closely, I'm doing it only at this end and not at the rest of the portion. And then turn it like this. Done. Now press it like this on this side. Now comes the sliding of the sleeving back again as much as possible. Yeah, next comes winding it like a coil.
Thank you.
I'm going to operate this newly made electric desoldering pump at 12 volts. This time I'm going to use this 12 volts transformer. You see, 230 volts to 12 volts. It's around 3 or 4 amps. DC, AC, RMS, true RMS, turning it on, and here we have 3.5 amperes. You see smoke, that's the close up. Now we need to test it. It's consuming around 46 to 50 watts. So here is a circuit board, and you see this capacitor, one of its leg is broken. So I'm going to remove it because I have to repair this power supply also. So that's the end point of it. Okay. So the supply has been turned on. Let's charge it. Done. Whoa. Oh, you see, I'm pushing this piston and it's doing like this. Pretty cool. So anyways, charging it once again. Wow, that was nice. Once again, you see, it actually desoldered. And the capacitor is out. Brilliant. So yeah, our electric desoldering pump is working good. Well guys, the setup is working really nice, except that there is one problem. I'll show you. You see, it's getting all like wobbly. The plastic is not strong enough to hold that high temperature. I think I will have to modify the desoldering pump, then only it is going to work. It is going to be a perfect piece. So let's do that. We are very close. So the first thing that we need is a soldering iron. Well, I had this piece lying around for many years, so I thought about using this in this project. So I'm going to use this heating filament from the soldering iron in between the desoldering pump and the tip, the metal tip that I just made using my lathe machine. And the sole purpose of using this part from the soldering iron is to prevent the high temperatures that are going to develop on my newly made tip from transferring to the plastic parts of my desoldering pump. Now guys, I've done two changes. First one you can already see is the power supply. I've removed the transformer and I'm going to use this 12 volts 8 amperes power supply this time, and I'm going to turn it on. See, red light glowing, so it's on. Now to the desoldering pump, I have added another step. Now initially this piece that you see, this was connected directly through this black piece, so it was heating a lot. So I've created another step. I have used this white high temperature PVC sheet and then another metal piece, brass piece in between, to create a further step for heat distribution. Plus there is another final change, which as you can see is the brass tip that I made using my lathe machine. Now the video was getting really long, so I didn't include the parts in between, but I have explained to you all of them in detail. Yeah, it's working. Okay, brilliant. Wow, now it's working great. Once again, cool. And now I have to desolder these three points also, because for placing of the new capacitors I will have to remove the remaining legs. So guys, here as you can see that I have covered the joints with the high temperature sleeving, and it looks quite nice this time. And guys, I also wanted to introduce you to a new member of my workshop family, this beautiful toolbox manufactured by BuildSkill. And I also like the color combination, it is so amazing. And as you can see that it opens quite easily, and it has 5 compartments, with 4 being medium compartments and one a really big compartment, the lower one. And guys, the best part is that it is really strong. It is made of steel and it is quite big, so it's very spacious for all of my tools. So guys, if you want to buy it, link has already been provided in the description. You can check it out.